Census now. Every 5 years, you get your opportunity to participate in the national census. Most of us do. There was a phenomenal response rate this time of 96.1%, up from where it was 95% odd in 2016. Now, the details out today all relate back to Tuesday, the 10th of August last year. And it's a snapshot of Australia on that night. Now, it's worth noting too, the census is self-identifying. No one verifies the record, but it's a data set that first began in 1911, so it provides pretty exceptional information, not just on the here and now, but our trends over time. Population is now 25.5 million of us, up 8.5% from 2016, or up by 2 million people, meaning we've doubled the population in the last 50 years. What else did we find out? Well, joining me now is a social researcher and founder of McCrindle Research, Mark McCrindle, to work through some of the detail. Mark, thank you for your time. Now, for the first time in history, the millennials have tied with baby boomers as the largest generation group. What kind of impact does a shift like that have on a nation?
Yeah, it's pretty phenomenal, Peter. 5.4 million of these millennials that are now in their late 20s, 30s, are pushing closer to 40. And so they are really in the family forming years. They're more than a third of the workforce at the moment. They have had in the last 10 years, the first 10 years of really their family years, they've had more than 3 million children, which actually is more than the 10 years prior that the previous generation had. So, you know, far from being the sort of the slackers, sometimes referred to as, you know, don't know what hard work is and all of this, they're actually contributing and making a difference, having an impact. They've got that big demographic power as the largest generation now, with that an economic power as well in the key expense and consumer years. As I said, in the workforce, they're leaders and influencers there. Interesting data on the millennials regarding Defence Force service, which was a new question in the census. 48% of those who wear uniform are millennials. So they make up almost half of serving Defence Force personnel as well. So making a great contribution and really, you know, changing Australia as they move through the demographics into this this influenced life stage.
Now, I asked this with a bit of self-interest because I'm Gen X. All throughout the sort of the debate about census that I've been involved in for nearly 30 years, we've focused heavily on the boomers because the boomers have sort of changed the culture of the countries they're in, given their size in numbers as they've moved along the life's journey. Now we're all talking about the millennials, poor old Gen X, we've just faded into the background. We sit between these two big demographic groups. Why have they sort of leapfrogged us in attention?
Well, that's true. As a fellow Gen Xer, we're sort of like the middle child, get totally overlooked. And partly it's because of the size of the Gen Ys. They are larger and they're sometimes called the echo boomers because they are the children of the baby boomers. The baby boomers were the largest generation ever seen, and 2.5 to 3 decades later, they began their families. And so the Gen Ys or millennials are the now the largest generation as well because of that. And having been born really since the 1980s in times of economic prosperity, stability, the baby boomers were happy to have more children than we'd seen for a little while. And so we've got this echo boom of Gen Ys or millennials, even bigger than the Gen Xs that went before, and obviously the focus is on these key social influences, the millennials, and so yes, us Gen Xs have been overlooked in the mix.
An interesting thing someone said to me, a demographer said to me too, with the Xs who finished school and university in the middle of the Keating recession, they are more like their grandparents out of that depression era, in terms of the concern about job security and frugality and all of those things, than perhaps their baby boomer parents who grew up in the time of plenty in that post-war boom. That then brings us, of course, to migration, what I thought was very interesting. We've now got more than half, so a majority of Australians that were either born overseas or who had a parent that was born overseas. That's pretty interesting.
It sure is. Yeah, we are a nation of migrants, and that continues apace. That's a key part. In fact, the bulk of what has grown our population over these 5 years. And it's interesting looking at the countries of birth as well. And India has done a bit of a leapfrog there. And after
Australian-born. Absolutely.
And moved right up the ranks, having overtaken China and New Zealand as well. So big changes there as we connect more, not so much with Europe, but with our part of the world in terms of Asia. And on the language front, Punjabi was the fastest growing language spoken in Australia in the 5 years of the most recent census period as well.
Talk to me about religion. I sort of started at the top of the show talking about religion and no religion. And then once you get into religion, breaking down the very different faith groups, it's still overwhelmingly, if you are of a religion, if you nominate a religion, it is of a Christian religion, and Catholicism is the largest of the Christian religions. But what sort of a trend are we seeing here in terms of Australians moving away from faith? I presume, Mark, this is happening around the Western world.
Yeah, it is. This has been a trend we've seen over the last few census, significant declines in the proportion identifying their faith as Christianity. In 2016, it was 52%. This time round, it's 44%. So a significant drop there. We saw no religion rise over the same five-year period from 30% to 39%. So increasingly secular times. But you know, we do need to lean into this figure a little bit. What's happening is that Australians are only choosing Christianity or any of the faith boxes if it's an active and current faith or practice. It used to be filled in. People are quick to say that 50 years ago, more than 9 in 10 of us selected Christianity. Now it's less than half. But back then you selected it because it was like your ancestry. And Australians still tick. There are more Australians that identify their ancestry as English than Australian, you know, even though it goes back a few generations. Mm-hmm. They did the same with faith. Oh, well, I'm not exactly active, but I think my parents or my grandparents were this or that. So that determined it. These days, people say, look, if I'm not believing it, I'm not going to put it down. So it's a more solid 44% is what we're saying. It's no longer just a cultural Christianity just going with the flow. And so we can rely on the figure a bit more as a true state of faith in Australia.
Oh, Mark McCrindle, that was fascinating. I'm going to keep picking my way through it. There's a lot there in that data, but it's a good sense of where the country is. I know it's self-identifying, but we get it every 5 years, and I think it is absolutely worth the read and the time tonight. Thank you. Thank you for your...